Hi, Miklos Kremser here with a quick market research example that I hope you'll find insightful. So I get a lot of requests for max diff analysis. As companies are looking to prioritize marketing messages, product features, competing offerings, and I always get asked, is a TERF analysis necessary? So for any of you doubters out there, I found an example project from the past that I think will illustrate the point very well. In this example, a mobile communications company was looking to reach the largest market with a handful of attractive promotions. And I changed the actual marketing messages a bit, so I'm not revealing any confidential information, but the point is still very relevant. Take a look at this example. So in this example, the mobile communications company was testing 10 marketing promotions. As you can see, these range from offering unlimited data, parental controls, to offering Disney Plus for a year, or Hulu, Netflix, Amazon streaming for a purchase of a family plan, to leasing an iPhone 11 for a year for only $9 a month. But what minimal combination of these will appeal to the largest market? So first we ran a max diff analysis to see which of these are the most and least appealing. And as you can see, the ranking on the left-hand side, as you can see, offering the lease on iPhone 11 for only $9 a month is the most appealing. Followed by Hulu, Netflix, and Amazon streaming for free for a year when you purchase a family plan. Naturally, what I'm tempted to do is to activate these promotions and see what my reach will be. Clicking on the most popular, which is leasing an iPhone 11 for a year for $9 a month, will appeal to 43% of the market. That is great. Now let's add the second most popular, offering Hulu, Netflix, and now I'm appealing to almost two-thirds of the market. With only these two promotions, I'm appealing to 62% of my market. Okay, let's also add the third most popular promotion, which is Disney Plus. But as you can see, my reach has increased only a tiny bit, only 3 percentage points. How can that be when Disney Plus was the third most popular? In fact, let's uncheck Hulu and only keep the most popular promotion and Disney Plus. And as you can tell, even with these two, I'm appealing to 64% of the market. The reason for this is because the people Hulu and Netflix appeal to are likely the same people Disney Plus appeals to. So I'm not gaining new people by offering both. It would be very wasteful business decision to offer both, and as a business I would need to pay subscription to Disney, Hulu, Netflix, and Amazon, while really I would not increase my customer base enough to make up for it. In fact, take a look, if I unclick Hulu and Netflix right here and just keep Disney Plus, my reach decreases by only 1 percentage point. Take a look. Okay, but likely as a company, I would save millions of dollars by not paying for those fees. This is a great example of why TERF analysis is critical to measuring reach by investigating the various combinations of offering. It's a cost and benefit analysis. So now that I know I don't have to offer Hulu and Netflix to increase my reach beyond what Disney Plus already accomplished, I can look to offer more incremental gain by offering, for example, unlimited data right here. And I've reached, with only these four, 3/4 of the market. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, as I hope to post market research related content, especially on topics I get a lot of questions about. So thanks again. See you next time.